So the adapter is what we are calling a helper class, in that it's not going to, we can't see our adapter right here. All we can see, of course, is the activity or the page, which is called the scientist activity. Now, the adapter is going to be responsible for actually rendering this particular data, as you can see in our recycler view. Okay, so this right here is a recycler view. Now you can see we can scroll through the recycler view, load more data, you can scroll up and down. However, it is the adapter that is responsible for loading these individual rows. You guys can see that each individual row comprises of a material letter icon, this round one right here. Then we have a text view for showing the name, then a text view for showing the description, then a text view for showing the galaxy. Now it is the adapter that will be responsible for actually rendering data into these individual widgets. Okay, so our adapter will first start by obtaining the initials of this particular name, okay, and then showing them in the material letter icon. It will also be responsible for inflation of those particular individual widgets. Now, inflation basically means that you are taking those widgets from our XML layout and converting them into view objects that you guys can see right here. Okay, so the main objectives of this class, of course, is first, over adapter will be, or of this class is first how to see how to inflate. Now, to inflate, we're going to do that one inside a method called the onCreateViewHolder. It's a method of overriding from our recyclerView.adapter. We're going to perform our inflation right there, okay? And then we'll also set the background for these particular letter icons. You can see they're actually random backgrounds, okay? As we scroll, we are changing those background colors randomly. We'll see that one inside. We'll learn how to do that one in one of the classes in this particular section. Then, of course, when we click an item, then you are able to view, open the detail page. Okay, those click events, we're going to listen to them inside our MyAdapter. If I come and then attempt to search right here, okay, then you guys can see that we are able to search filter. Now, searching filter, this will take place, of course, inside our MyAdapter. Okay, now, of course, as we are searching, you guys can see that we are highlighting. Okay, you can see the highlight, we're highlighting right there. We are highlighting, of course, the query. Now, that will also take place in our MyAdapter. Okay, so that's where we're going to do it, right there inside the MyAdapter. So basically, MyAdapter is going to derive from the recyclerView.myAdapter. Then we're going to have what is called a view holder class, which is going to hold these individual widgets for recycling. So that's it. That's the main objective for this particular section. Guys, we come right here to what we're calling MyAdapter. Now, MyAdapter is very important. This is an important class. It's going to be our adapter, okay? So, of course, if you've worked with the Android development before, then you know, of course, the roles of adapters. In Android, like in most mobile development framework, normally you need to display lists of data, okay? And in Android, the default view for doing that is the recycler view. However, recycler view itself is a view object. It's actually independent of the data source. So it is the adapter that normally connects the adapter view, or like a recycler view, to the data source. Okay, that's one of the roles of the adapter. Another function of the adapter is that we use them, of course, to inflate custom views that we can show in our recycler view. So views that like recycler view and list view and grid view, they don't just show simple text, they can show images, they can show video, they can show all of these different type of views, buttons, radio buttons, checkboxes, okay? So for us to be able to do that one, we normally need to define a custom layout. Like in my case, I have defined a custom layout for my recycler view called model.xml, okay? No, this is the file who sits under the layouts. So we looked at the model.xml and we said that this view will get inflated into a single view item. You can see some of the components that it contains or the widgets. So that inflation, basically turning them from XML into a view object, that will take place inside my adapter. Okay, yeah, so let's create this adapter and see how it's going to do all those. So this is our adapter class. It has the following roles. First, it will inflate our model layout into a view, then subsequently recycle those views. Then it will bind data to that view for all rows, making our recycler view. Then thirdly, it will show name initials in icons with random icon background color applied. Fourthly, it will listen to click events of recycler view items and pass the clicked item to another activity. So public class MyAdapter extends recyclerview.adapter MyAdapter.viewHolder. Okay, this is what we are doing right here. You can see to create a recyclerview adapter, you have to extend or inherit from recyclerview.adapter class. However, this is a generic class, so you need to supply the generic parameter. Now, in our case, in this adapter, normally this generic parameter is the view holder. Okay, remember, the adapter has all these roles, but then it needs the help of a view holder to hold the views that is going to recycle. So for this recycling, the way recycler will recycle this particular views is that it will make use of what we call a view holder pattern. So view holder, basically, as we're going to define it, we're going to see it in a short while, is just a class that will contain the individual widgets. Okay, those widgets which were defined in our layout, it's going to hold them so that we can reuse them across different rows. Okay, so that's what we're doing now. MyAdapter.viewHolder, because viewholder, we're going to define it inside this MyAdapter class. So this is why we are referencing it using this dot operator. So let's proceed. Private context C, private final typed value, m typed value equal to new typed value, private int m background, private int array m material colors, private list scientists, public string such string equal to empty. These are our instance fields. Okay, we have them right as our instance fields. Such string will represent the such string that the user types. Then list right here is a list of scientists. Material colors, these are the material colors which we're going to show in our material letter icon. Then this will represent, of course, the background for those particular icons. Okay, now this typed value object, we're going to use it while inflating, of course, our material letter icon. Remember, we're going to have, of course, some attributes. In fact, if we go over to our, let's come right here to our values, we are having these attributes.xml. okay, so we have some attributes for material letter icon, like the color, the border color, border size, etc. All these attributes. So later on in our constructor, we're going to be resolving those attributes, and one of the objects that we're going to need for that one is going to be this typed value. Then you also have the context object, which will assist with the inflation of our custom views. Now, before we go into that one, let's come and create this my view holder right here. Okay, it's probably giving you an error right here. So let's come and define this particular class. We are creating it as an inner class. So our view holder class, its responsibility will be first to hold all the widgets which will be recycled by the recycler view and then reference them. Secondly, to implement click event. Now, public class view holder extends recyclerview.viewholder, implements view.onClickListener. Then private text view, name txt, description txt, and galaxy txt. Private material letter icon, m icon. Private item click listener, item click listener. So this is our view holder class. It's implementing a view dot on click listener, meaning that we'll have to override the on click method. But before that one, we have these widgets. Okay, now these are the widgets which will be shown in an item view of our recycler view: name, description, and galaxy. Then the icon right here, we have them as private fields. However, we're going to assign them values inside the constructor, which is mandatory for us to define. Okay, now this item click listener, this is an interface, a custom interface. We'll define it later on. It's going to hold for us one method which will represent our on item click. Now we'll see how to use it later on. Let's come and start by creating our constructor for this particular class. Okay, so we reference our widgets inside this constructor: public view holder, view item view, then super item view, then m icon equal to item view dot find view by id r dot id dot material letter icon, name txt item view dot find view by id r dot id dot name txt, description item view dot find view by id r dot id the description txt, galaxy txt find view by id r dot id dot galaxy txt, item view dot set on click listener this. Okay, so this right here, you can see this is the way we are referencing our widgets. Basically we're using the find view by id. However, you have to call this method, okay, from a view object. Now that view will be passed to us. Actually, this view that is being passed to us, it will represent the inflated view. Okay, that model, once it's been inflated into a single card view for a recycler view, we'll use it to reference our widgets using find view by id. Okay, then item view dot set on click listener, we're going to listen to the click events. Now let's go ahead and then override the on click method for this particular view dot on click listener. At override public void on click view view, this dot item click listener dot on item click this dot get layout position, then public void set item click listener item click listener item click listener this dot item click listener equal to item click listener. Let me explain what we've done. First, we've overridden the on click. You can see it's receiving a view object. Now then we come this dot item click listener. So remember, when the user clicks a single card view, this is what we're going to do. We're going to get the layout position for our recycler view. This get layout position will give us the current position of the item. This is important because this is how we know the item that's been clicked, okay, from the value, the integer that we receive from this layout position. Then we pass it to on item click. Now this on item click, it's a method that we're going to define inside our item click listener interface. We've not yet defined this interface. We're going to define it in a short while. But of course, if these are clicks, if this on click right here is raised, then we're going to also, of course, invoke that on item click. Okay, pass it over to our on item click. Now we have this method called set item click listener, which basically allow us to receive an item click listener instance and then set it to the local one that we have. Okay, so this therefore will make our view holder class. Now let's continue with the adapter. Take note of these ones. We are continuing with the adapter class. So my adapter's constructor now. So public my adapter, context m context array list scientists, this dot c equal to m context, this dot scientists equal to scientists, then c dot get theme dot resolve attributes, then r dot hr dot selectable item background, then m typed value, then true, then material letter icons equal to c dot get resources dot get int array r dot array dot colors m background m typed value dot resource id. This constructor right here, first we receive a context object which will be injected to us via the as a parameter. and also the list of scientists. Then we invoke the resolve attributes, okay? So r.htr.selectableItemBackground, we defined it, of course, in our htr.xml. So if we go right here, we have all these attributes right here, which, of course, we're going to be applying, of course, into our MyAdapter. Then, of course, material colors, we obtain them from our r.colors. Okay, so if we r.array.colors, if we go over to arrays, we have all these colors right here, which we're going to apply to our letter icons. Okay, then, of course, background, mTypeValue.resourceID, we'll set that one to our background. We do all this inside the constructor of our MyAdapter. Now we override the onCreateViewHolder method. This is where we will inflate our model.xml layout, which we said, okay, we'll inflate it into a view object and then set its background color. So at null, at override public view holder on create view holder, then at null view group parent int view view type, view view equal to layout inflator.from, then context, then inflate, then the layout, okay, then view.set background resource and background, then view holder vh equal to new view holder, then return vh, okay, on create view holder. Basically, the main thing we're doing right here is to inflate our model.xml layout. We turn it into a view object. You can see we use the layout inflator class, and then we're going to pass that view object into our view holder constructor and then return the resultant view holder object. Okay, let's proceed. So our view holder class, our unbind view holder class, so at override public void onBind view holder at null view holder holder int position, then we get our current scientist. So we come and say final scientist s equal to scientist.get, we pass the position, then we bind data to our widgets, holder.nameTxt.setText s.getName, holder.description.setText s.getDescription, holder.galaxyTxt.setText s.getGalaxy, holder.timeIcon.setInitials to true, then holder.timeIcon.setInitialsNumber to holder.timeIcon.setLetterSize 25, holder.timeIcon.setShapeColor materialColors new random.nextInt materialColors.length, then holder.timeIcon.setLetter s.getName. Okay, so basically what we are doing right here, okay, what we are doing right here, these are on bind view holder, these are going to bind our data to our recycler view. So you can see first we need to obtain the current item or the current scientist, we use the position to do that, then we obtain the name, description, galaxy, and then bind them. Okay, then we also set the material letter icon properties like the initials number, letter size, etc, shape color, we set all those, then we set the letter. Those letters we're going to obtain them from the name. Okay, let's proceed. So before we start typing the code, remember guys, we said and we actually saw in the demo that our application was involved highlighting our search results. Okay, so this is the code that we're going to type, is the code that will allow us to highlight. Now we're going to highlight the names and the galaxy. So let's see, of course, how to do this highlighting in code. First and foremost, we get the name and galaxy. So string name equal to s.getName.lowercase locale.getDefault, then string galaxy s.getGalaxy.lowercase locale.getDefault. Now we're going to highlight our name text while searching. So if name dot contains such string and not such string dot is empty, then int start position equal to name dot index of such string, int end position equal to such start position plus such string dot length, then spannable span string equal to spannable dot factory dot get instance, then dot new spannable holder dot name txt dot get text, then span string dot set span new foreground color span color dot thread, then start position end position, then spannable dot span exclusive exclusive, then holder dot name txt dot set text span string. Else we can show that such string is empty. Okay, basically this is how we're going to be highlighting. First we search using the contains method, then we obtain the position and the start position and the end position, and then we use the spannable right here to of course highlight. Okay, now we just set the span, then the foreground color color dot thread, we apply the position and start position and end position, and then this is going to highlight for us. Okay, so this is highlighting the name. The galaxy is the same thing right here, but we'll replace name and galaxy. Let's see how to do that. So we highlight galaxy text while searching. So if galaxy dot contains such string and not such string dot is empty, then int start position equal to galaxy dot index of such string, int end position equal to start position plus such string dot length, then spannable span string equal to spannable dot factory dot get instance dot new spannable holder dot galaxy txt dot get text, then span string dot set span new foreground color span color dot blue start position end position, then spannable dot span exclusive exclusive holder dot galaxy txt dot set text span string. Okay, next we're going to open our detail activity. When clicked, holder dot set item click listener position lambda expression right here, utils dot send scientist to activity, then detail activity dot class. So basically right here, this last line, this is allowing us to open the detail activity when the user clicks the current activity. Okay, so this is it, this is what we're doing right here. Remember set item click listener, we defined it, if you guys remember, in our my view holder class. Okay, however we're still yet to define our interface. We promise to define this item click listener interface, we're using it now, we're going to define it in a short while right here. Okay, so let's proceed. So at override public int get item count, return scientist dot size interface int item click listener, void on item click, then int position. So what have we done? Well, item count get item count, we're overriding it inside our my adapter. Please make sure that you supply the size of the scientist. Okay, so if you forget and you leave it at zero, then of course your items will not show in our recycler view. So scientist dot size, this is what will determine the number of items that the recycler view will show. Now we come, then we define our interface. Okay, this is just an interface, so it has one abstract method without a body. Now you can see the method will receive an integer right here, so this is it. Okay, yeah, so this is it guys, this is our my adapter right here. You can see the whole of it. Okay, my adapter.java. So let's proceed over to our next class.